There he is. Look, he's already pouring sweat, getting ready to go out in front of thousands of people, and is expected to give them one of the very best weekends of their lives every single time. Boom. What's he doing right there? How does he get himself into that absolute peak state so he can perform every single time? I've gone through a bunch of his old videos and backwards engineered exactly what he does. And in this video, I'm going to show you those seven insane rituals. And at the end, I'm going to go through his hand clapping ritual, which is completely out of control and actually just morphed into something else last weekend at his Unleash the Power Within event. But let's start with number six, and then we'll go back to the beginning. Check this out. He's getting ready to go on stage right now. Look me in the eye and tell me he's not trying to be MC Hammer.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
But he should definitely be paying Hammer royalties for those moves. But let's start right at the beginning. It starts at his house, and the first thing that he does when he wakes up before an event is to meditate. Now, meditating is kind of polarizing. Some people think it's life-changing, and some people think it's complete mumbo-jumbo. But people who believe in it believe that it helps clear your mind of kind of the constant buzz of thoughts that are always coursing through your brain. It makes it easier to be fully present because, say, 50% of your brain is just filled up with those hum of thoughts in the background that are always coming in and out. When you're able to purge your brain of that 50%, you can allocate 100% of your brain to being present. And when he goes out on stage, the biggest thing that he's focusing on is being present to suck people in to his reality. Now, Tony has incredibly powerful pipes, and the second ritual helps him with this. When he begins talking, he commands attention, respect, and immediately positions himself as someone who's both confident and influential. Let's listen to a little bit of him talking right here.
$60,000 a year for your retirement. The person who got $432,000, it's going to last till they're 79. And
a hugely underrated amount of Tony's success is due only to his voice. So the way Tony warms up his voice is first with vocal and posture training. So you can see he's sitting here with a block between his legs and he's sitting straight up to ensure his posture's right. And he starts by warming up with that. Then he progresses to more traditional vocal warm-ups, like someone who's going on stage, like an opera singer or an actor would do before they go on, kind of hitting different scales and also holding the specific resonance that his voice travels on. You can hear him doing it right here.
No, 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 no.
Baron Crows, love his show. Okay, so now his voice is nice and warmed up, so when he goes on stage, he knows those first words will command attention, and there's no chance he's going to come out with a screechy voice like it happens right when you wake up and aren't warmed up. Okay, there's Tony right there jumping off the trampoline. No, that's not Tony, but this actually is Tony. He takes a cold plunge into water that's chilled and held to exactly 57 degrees.
57 degrees, baby. Whoa.
I did a triathlon once in college, and it was an open water swim, and the water's like 62 degrees. I was wearing a wetsuit, and all the skin that was exposed, like my arms, it was so cold. I can't even imagine what 57 degrees feels like. But what it does, the proponents of it, say that it stimulates your nervous system to release hormones, which promote a fight or flight response, which makes you feel ultra alert and invigorated. In the words of Tony, he says, I don't do it because I'm a misogynist. I do it because there's nothing that can change everything in your system like a radical change in temperature. So once he gets out the cold plunge, cleans up, gets dressed, and jumps in his motorcade that looks like something that the president would use and shows up, okay? Now he's walking in. You can see he's already in a good mood. He's smiling. He's got peak energy. He's got a lot of confidence right now. Okay, what happened right there? His wife shot liquid supplements into his mouth. Now, all we can do is speculate. I'm speculating that it's ginseng because a lot of people think ginseng gives you an immediate energy boost. Why else would he do it so close to when he gets on stage? That is speculation I don't know, but I know a lot of my buddies who are really into health and fitness say ginseng helps with that, and that was their guess, so I'm gonna go with that, all right? So straight from the ginseng to what? Now he is bouncing on a trampoline. He talks about always being a big proponent of the mind-body connection. And so he says he tricks his brain by changing his physiology to help him get excited and alert. He says movement in itself can be therapeutic, and he changes his state by changing his physiology. So he feels like that little bouncing up and down, he only does it for about 10, 15 seconds, but he feels like that's kind of the final touch to up the energy. All right, we're back to it. MC Hammer's backup dancer. When he does this, it leverages the power of a study that came out years ago, not a long time ago, I think maybe 5 years ago, about power poses. So he's doing one more change in his physiology with a quick spin, you know, like when you were a kid and you got on the playground and they'd spin, I don't even know what that thing's called, he'd spin it around, you get kind of dizzy. It makes you completely confused, but it changes his physiology. He's doing a micro dose of that to amp his energy. But then what does he do there? The gorilla, the pat on the chest. That is considered a power pose. There was a study that was done that showed mock interview candidates, and 20 of them were forced to do, or told to do, I guess they weren't forced, but they were told to get into very unconfident body positions. So shoulders slumped, eyes down, loose muscles. And then the other group were told to get into powerful positions, hands on shoulders, even hands up in the air, like they won something, like, yes, I'm the best. To do these 10 minutes before they went into a mock interview. And the people that held the power poses versus the more supplicative, non-confident poses came across way, way, way better. The statistical significance of this study was huge. So basically, what he's doing there at the end is just pumping himself up. I'm the man. If you read about some of his incantations, which aren't appropriate, the things that he repeats to himself, he's a big proponent of gaining that confidence by physical and repeated motion, repeated things. So he's beating his chest, kind of like a monkey in the wild. I'm the man, right before he walks out, takes the stage. Peak energy, peak excitement, voice is warmed up. He's done everything to put himself in the perfect state. Now he's out on stage. Tony's clap is probably the most infamous throughout the world. He puts a ton of energy into it, but it looks weird. He's got this weird kind of corkscrewing of his hands. It's always been strange, but there's no denying there's massive amounts of energy behind it. So he relies on the concept of state transference to hype up the crowd. That's why he puts all this energy and effort into getting him to that state, because he knows people feel what you feel. This is a very, very solid principle just in everyday interaction. But he knows when he gets up on stage and he feels a perfect 10 out of 10, the more that he can show that through body movement, through smile, through talking, yelling, singing, the more he's gonna draw the crowd in to feeling that. That's how he's able to suck people in to his reality or his frame, because he has such a crazy outputting of it. And this hand clap is a crazy way for him to do it. Now, it started with somewhat humble beginnings. It's strangely hard to find video of his hand clap. I don't know what's going on, but here's one that I found of him like 6 years ago. You can see it's a bit more humble, a bit more reserved, but you can still see the strange kind of way his hands come together. Then it progressed to this. A lot more energy, a lot more comfort. He's moving around the stage more, right? So big exaggerated movements. He's got mitts that are the size of bears. So when he's clapping those things together, they probably make about 3 times the sound that you and I do. But you can see the energy and excitement behind it. Now, check this out. You see this? You see what's going on right here? His clap is so next level that he doesn't even clap anymore. He brings out 2 sticks to beat together. He bangs sticks together while running around stage instead of clapping now. Last weekend at his Unleash the Power Within event, he came out to Little John, Turn Down for What. That song was playing, banging sticks together with booty dancers on stage. Him getting himself into an insane high level of state, a high level of mentality, a super high energy, and then radiates that to the crowd in any way he can through his voice. Now through banging his sticks, through his physiology, through his smile, he's a giant man. There's no denying that he's one of the best in the world at doing this, and this is the way that he gets it done every time. Side note, Tony's website is one of the best in the business. He's gone from zero to over a million views every single month by using some very, very sharp best practices. My buddies over at Sumo just released an article about that, detailing exactly as a case study what he did to grow to this level. And if that's something that's interesting to you, you can click right here to check it out. Otherwise, if you haven't subscribed to the Sumo YouTube site, you can click here to do that. And if you want to see more videos like this, head over to my YouTube channel called The Charisma Matrix and subscribe there.